Right. So I want to share something with you. When I was very young, I had a dream. I had an ambition. And I worked very hard. I studied. And now I am a human resources officer. Anyone else work in the wonderful world of HR, as we call it? You do. You'll know how exciting it is if you do. So yes, I work in HR. But I made a decision a little while ago to leave all of that, because I've lived through so many reorganisations and downsizes, and I thought, fair enough. So I decided to go for voluntary redundancy. And it all kicked off a little while ago. Putting a message to my boss, and then I got a little email with a link to a page to press the VR button. Imagine this big button in the middle of the screen. It wasn't red. It was green. And I pressed it, and I thought, okay. And I got an email back later on when they'd done the calculations and when I was leaving and what I would be getting. And then they asked me, are you sure? Like those messages you get from the computer, you know, say, you sure you want to do this? And I pressed it again. And then I thought, okay, what's going to happen now? Where am I going? And what will I find? What's in this grab bag that I call my mind? What am I doing alone on the shelf? Ain't it a shame, but no one's to blame but myself. Which way is clear when you've lost your way? Year after year, do I keep falling in love for just the kick of it? Stumbling through the thin and thick of it, hating each old and tired trick of it. Know what I am, I'm good and sick of it. Where am I going? Why do I care? Run where it's fun, or run where it's fair. No matter where I go, I meet myself there. Looking inside me, what do I see? Anger and hope and doubt, what am I all about? Where am I going? You tell me. Which way is clear when you've lost your way? Year after year, do I keep falling in love for just the kick of it? Stumbling through the thin and thick of it, hating each old and tired trick of it. Know what I am, I'm good and sick of it. Where am I going? Why do I care? Run where it's far, run where it's fair. No matter where I go, I meet myself there. Looking inside me, what do I see? What am I all about? Where am I going? one big change in my life, but there's been a very positive change in my life in that I am no longer on the shelf. I may have sort of been approaching my best before date, but I haven't reached my use by date. So, there's life in the old dog yet. But I have had my share of one night stands in the past. I'm sure some of you have, I'm sure you have. And sometimes when you're with somebody, and you know it's a casual thing, but you're sort of caught up in the moment, sometimes your mind races ahead, or mine does anyway, and I think, oh, what if that person is the one? And you start making plans. Tonight your mind completely, you give your love so sweetly. Tonight the light of love is in your eyes, but will you love me tomorrow? Is this a lasting treasure, or just a moment's pleasure? Can I believe the magic of your sighs? Will you still love me tomorrow? Tonight, with words unspoken, you say that I'm the only one. But will my heart be broken when the night meets the morning sun? I need to know that your love is love I can be sure of. So tell me now, and I won't ask again. Will you still love me tomorrow? Tonight, with words unspoken, you say that I'm the only one. But will my heart be broken when the night meets the morning sun? I need to know that your love is love I can be sure of. So tell me now, and I won't ask again. Will you still love me tomorrow? Tomorrow. Someone's been sending me flowers. Oh, what a sweet thing to do. Every new day brings another bouquet, and I don't know who to say thank you to. Sometimes they come through the window, down through the chimney they fall. Sometimes at night, when I turn out the light, they come through a crack in the wall. Now that my house is a garden, all bursting with blossoms in bloom, I stand there for hours, admiring my flowers. I'd like to lie down, but there just isn't room. Someone's been sending me flowers, more than I ever have had. Remarkable stuff, but enough is enough. If I see another bouquet, I'll go mad. They started by sending me bluebells. Strangely enough, they were grey. Each nasty bloom had a nasty perfume. Besides being grey, they were paper mache. There followed a garland of fungus. Then, for a tropical treat, they sent me a plant which proceeded to pant and later began to eat meat. The cactus corsage touched me deeply. A lovely plant in its prime. I felt much the same when the rock garden came, one rock at a time. Somebody madly adores me. I don't know who they could be. I can't afford to be madly adored. I do wish you'd stop sending flowers. COD.
Yeah!
Thank you. Thank you.